Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in accounting. And our topic today is about standard cost, about recording standard cost. So about journal entries here. And when we talk about standard cost, we have four huge standard costs. Direct material, direct labor, variable manufacturing overhead, and fixed manufacturing overhead. We will check the journal entries of all these four standard costs and its variance. So we have four additional videos, one for each standard cost, and they are in our video description, as well as our Excel file. That is the one that we will be working with. The Excel files, all our Excel files, they are free to download it. And the link is in our video description. So here is our standard numbers, the same as our standard numbers here. So we will not be working on this video about how to find our variance, the formulas, and so on. But you can check it in our previous videos or check it in our Excel files. Okay, so here, standard numbers. Direct materials, number of cases produced, 41,000 for all of our areas. And direct materials purchased, 266.5 pounds at 260 per pound. So direct materials is the only one that we have two journal entries because we have two transactions, purchase and usage. All of the other ones, the purchase and users, they are the same because we don't have different inventories. Here we have direct materials inventory and work in process inventory. We cannot storage direct labor or variable or manufacturing overhead. So we will be working with only one journal entry for the others. So, okay, purchase. Purchase, we are talking about price variance. Let's do this one here together. So direct materials. Oh, and by the way, a golden rule here. Everything related to inventory, we are talking about standard cost. Everything related to cash or anything payable, we are talking about actual numbers. So accounts payable is our actual number. It's our actual purchase, 266 times 250. Or 260, sorry. 692, almost 693. Direct materials inventory, 266 times the standard price. And it's why here? Because we can control our variance in our journal entries. It's much easier to combine financial accounting and cost accounting. How do we find our price variance? We need to balance this journal entry, or as I always tell to my students, we need to balance this guy here. It is unbalanced, and we need a debit. So if we need a debit, how much? 692 less 666, $26,600. When we have a debit variance here, we have an unfavorable variance. So here, direct price variance, 26.6 unfavorable. Here about favorable and unfavorable, we can think just like the same as revenue and expenses. Expenses, bad, debit. Revenue, good, credit. Unfavorable variance, bad, debit. Favorable variance, good, credit. Okay, and how do we do that? Work in process, inventory, quantity variance, and so on. So how do we find this number here? So our work in process, so first of all, the easiest one, let's start with the first one. That's easy or hard, that depends on who you are talking with. So work in process inventory is our standard cost times our quantity. However, What about our direct materials inventory? Our direct materials inventory here. Our direct materials inventory will be the purchase times the standard cost. So it will be 666, the same one here as our direct materials inventory, because we are working with the same quantity here. And now, what do we need? We need a credit to balance it. So our quantity variance will be 51, and it is favorable variance. So here, direct materials, 51, favorable variance. What about direct labor? This is our numbers, 22,000 hours, $540,000, how much we pay it. So our average wage rate is 24.55. So, okay, here, what do we have? So let's delete it here. Working process inventory is our standard cost times our unit is our 512. Wage payable is our 540. Here, wow, we will combine both variants, so we cannot balance to find our variance. However, what do we do? Calculate the easiest variance and the hardest variance you balance it on journal entry. In my opinion, the easiest variance is the rate variance, because the rate variance is different in prices. So difference in prices here, here, so, and it's easier to find if it is favorable or unfavorable. Standard price, 25. Actual price or rate, 24. So we have a favorable variance here. Our actual number is lower than our standard number. So it is a credit. So absolute credit here. So actual rate less standard rate times the number of hours. $10,000 favorable. Let's double check here, direct labor, $10,000 favorable. And now, the efficiency is a little bit harder to find it favorable or unfavorable. So now we can balance 512, 550. So we need a debit. So equal the sum of our credit less our debit. 37.5 unfavorable, 37.5 unfavorable. Okay, and let's talk about manufacturing overhead. One journal entry for a variable, one journal entry for a fixed. The variable manufacturing overhead data, actual hours, 18,450. Actual cost, 516.6. So our rate per hour will be 28, cost divided by hours. So let's do it here. Working process inventory, standard cost times number of units produced, 524. Payable is our actual cost. Okay, we need to balance here. Again, the easiest one to find it favorable or unfavorable, the rate variance. 28, actual rate. 32, standard rate. So we have a favorable variance here. So credit, journal entry. Where are you? Here. So rate, absolute difference in hours or difference of our rates. 32 less 28 times the number of hours, 34. So 73.8. Let's go back here, favorable, 73.8. So we are good here. And efficiency, we do our number two balance. We also need a debit here. Or guys, if we have these numbers here, it is much easier to record it. Okay, so we are doing a two in one here. Fixed. Fixed, we have budget costs, actual costs. And let's do it here. Payable. Payable is our actual costs. Budget variance is the easiest one here. We compare a budget with actual. Actual lower than budget, so we have a favorable variance. So ABS here, favorable variance. How do we find our work in process? It is not the budget number. This is the most common mistake. It is just like our other standard costs. It's our standard cost per case times number of units, 196. And what do we need here? 196, 200. We need a debit. So equal credits less our debit, 3,200. Let's double check here. 10,000 favorable, 3,200 unfavorable. So we are good to go. Guys, if this video was very fast, I'm sorry, but you can see it any how many times you want at any time, anywhere. So guys, thank you so much. Subscribe our channel. You will be the first one to know when a new video arrives. Like our video, like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin. And if you have questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a very nice day and God bless you.